Thank you for tuning in and watching. Today we're picking mushrooms. So the mushroom we're looking for in particular grows next to pine, and it looks like this. The question about this mushroom is that when you're picking it, you have very slimy fingers. In other words, your fingers get pretty dirty. Here's another one right here. These things are yummy. These things grow all over the place. You just gotta know where to find them. So the way you check these things, if they have bugs, if they're still good, is you cut them in half and you open them up, and they're supposed to be hole free. This one, unfortunately, if you can tell, it has dark spots on the inside of the stem where the bugs have traveled in. And all that discoloration is actually bugs living in there, and this mushroom is no good, unfortunately, so we're gonna discard it. But there are plenty others like these. Hopefully, there we go. Pretty hard to spot if you don't know what you're looking for, but once you've picked one of these, you really know what they look like. This one full of bugs. And like I said earlier, I've touched three of these so far and my fingers are pretty dirty already. They are yummy though, so we're not stopping here. I'm gonna continue. There we go. There you have a perfectly good stem. So this mushroom, slimy cap, very slimy. It gets your fingers extremely dirty really quick. Yellow bottom, and as you can see, there are no blades here. This is a spongy like texture, like so. And when you cut these guys open, you're looking for no holes all the way through. And this is a perfectly good mushroom right here. That's a perfect example of a really good one. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to leave it here. I'm going to leave this guy here. And I'm going to continue with this bad boy, which happens to be the other one that grew right beside it. First of all, stem already has hole in it. And what you do is you cut the stem away until those holes disappear. If the holes do not disappear by the time you're at the head, that means the bugs have traveled into the head of the mushroom and as such render it useless. This one's perfect actually. Nothing traveled into it. It's 1st of October and I have mosquitoes flying around me. It's crazy. Perfectly healthy. Notice how this one has a really dark stem right here. Once again, bugs, once again evident, are on the bottom of the head. And as you cut the mushroom in half, you'll notice that the mushroom cap is just riddled with channels burrowed by the bugs. No good. Here's a perfect example of what not to pick. The difference in this mushroom in particular are the blades on the back. You see how that's no longer a mesh? This guy, who knows what it would do to me, but it's so perfect. Nothing is eating it, probably for a very good reason. And usually poisonous mushrooms don't get eaten by bugs for various reasons. One, they could be poisonous. Two, the bugs know something we don't. Stay away from anything that's perfect in a forest. Rule of thumb. This guy is no longer good. It's too much moisture. They're getting old and too slimy. Here's a perfect example of a mushroom we should never pick. As a rule of thumb, anything that has these spots on it, stay away from. Mm-hmm.